Everyone, this is Harris Delalić, and I'm the product manager for group import here at GitLab. Today, I'm going to walk through a migration from GitHub into GitLab to show the current user experience and note any opportunities for improvement. I'll start by logging into my GitHub account and review my data there before migration. So this is my GitHub account where I have created an organization in order to see how much of that and in what way can I migrate into GitLab. My organization has two repositories, the website and the backend. The repositories have a couple of files in them each. They're associated, different issues are associated with different projects. And the issues have elements such as labels, embedded images, and comments with images on them. In addition to the repositories, I have also created teams in order to see if and how that might get reflected in GitLab. In this case, I have four different teams, one of which is a subteam of a higher level team. So with that in mind, I'm going to switch over to GitLab in order to engage the migration and transfer my data from GitHub into GitLab. So first I'm gonna have to find the import feature. It is right behind the new project button on this view. So this view is the group that I've created. I'm gonna use this group to migrate data into it. And to move the data from GitHub, we really need to create a new project. That project will then get the data from GitHub populated into it. The project will belong to this group. I can create a new project either directly from the group overview page, or I can engage creation of a new project or a new subgroup from anywhere in the product by using the plus add option in the top level nav. So the new project page gives me several options. One is to create a blank project. Another one is to create a project from a template. And I see that the import project is one of the options to create a new project. And from description here, I can tell that it does support at least GitHub and Bitbucket or another instance of GitLab, among other sources. So here I can see all the different choices where I can get my data migrated from. And in my case, I'm going to select GitHub. I have already provided GitLab with my GitHub credentials, which then led me to this view here. I can tell already that I have once migrated a private project from GitHub into GitLab, and that was completed. And I have a link to go see that project here. If I had a lot of different projects that I had visibility into in GitHub, I could potentially use the filter here to find just the projects that that match a search criteria. I'm not sure exactly why this doesn't work, but it seems that if I try to filter the repositories by name, I'm not able to see anything if I type in team, for example, which is a which is contained in the projects that I have in GitHub. Maybe it's the actual project name, not the organization name. Yeah, all right, so that's what it is. So the filter works in such a way that it looks only for projects, which in this case are private, public, backend, and website. And those are the ones that would show up in here. Okay, so I can decide where in GitLab I would like these projects to be migrated to. So in this particular case, I actually want to select that group that I was looking at earlier to move the backend and the website projects into. It seems that I can import all three repositories that are shown here. So the three that are importable, I should be able to import them by clicking on the import three repositories button. It'd be nice if I can just select, you know, several, but not all repositories to import. So if I wanted to import, you know, these two from the team, get it done, and not necessarily this other public project I belong to. If I wanted to exclude a project, it'd be nice to do that, to be able to just checkbox these and then start import. But in this case, I'm just gonna kick off two separate imports. So clicking on import and clicking on the other import, what I see is that one of them has gotten going and it's running. I see that the button that says import multiple repositories is spinning as well, which I didn't expect that to be engaging or that to be a spinner. I would expect it to be grayed out because I'm not importing multiple repositories at a time. But it's just odd that there's also a spinner there. I wonder if I should just wait for the importers to complete here and whether I'll be able to just see the site refreshed, or do I need to hit refresh? So I don't think it'll hurt if I just refresh this to see if there's better data there, and there was. So clearly the page did not refresh or did not refresh, you know, quickly enough for me to be able to see the progress, but both of those imports were done. And I'm now provided with a link to go to the project in GitLab. At the same time, there's also a link here so I can go back to the project in GitHub and compare the two, which is something that I will want to do. So I'll open up the backend project in GitHub, and at the same time, I'm gonna open up the same project in GitLab and kind of compare the two and see what got migrated and how it'll work out. So looking at GitHub, the name of the project was backend, and then there was a description that says the server portion of the product, and it seems that both the name and the description have been moved across. I see that my commits have been migrated across as well as the two files that I had in the repo. So three commits, two files. I'll take a look at the commits to just see what that looks like. So yeah, these were the comments that I've made when I made those commits. So I created the SQL, I did some initial commit, created the SQL data file, and then made another change to restore the tables. So it does seem that the commits are all there. So now next thing I would like to take a look at are the issues. It does say three here, so that gives me confidence that my three issues were moved across. The three issues I had, there was out of those three issues, one was I thought that one of them was closed, but apparently it was not closed. So that's something we'll have to try next time, is to make sure that if an issue is closed, that it comes across as closed. So three open issues. And the labels seem to have come across. Interestingly enough, which is kind of cool, the label colors have made it across as well. And the milestones that these issues were associated with, which were, which in this case was the R2 for the issue number one, also seem to have made it across into milestones. So there's a milestone that's defined as R2, and this issue is now associated with the milestone. So this happens every now and then, really. Not sure what to do other than refresh to make that go away. So the issue seems to have come across pretty well, including the embedded image that I had in the issue. And additionally, I have also, I also see the comment that I've made. That comment was created by a user, by a GitHub user that does not have an account in GitLab. So I see this note here that says that it was created by this user, and the actual comment and the issue are all associated with my GitLab user, which is the one that performed the import. So that's as expected. I'm curious if the issue that had the image in the comments, if those images have come across as well. So let's take a look at the issue number two. And yeah, it seems that the image from the comment has made it across as well. So far, everything that I expected to be there has made it across. As I suspected, the users, if they're not in GitLab, they're not gonna get mapped, and they're not gonna get moved from GitHub into GitLab either in any kind of automated way. The teams, that concept just, it doesn't seem like it mapped to anything or it got moved in any particular way. But that's also sort of to be expected, because the import that I've done was at the level of the project, each project being one of these repositories. So I moved this repository and that repository out of GitHub. I did not move packages or people or teams or projects. So those are entities that do not get mapped or moved in any way. Really what gets mapped and moved across is kind of sort of everything that belongs with the repositories. And in that case, what I end up with is projects in the group that I've selected. So if I go take a look at the group, I do see the two projects that I've migrated over. So I guess there are some steps that I would need to do manually in order to really mirror the entire organization from GitHub into GitLab, namely the users and the teams would need to be mapped manually at this point. And I wonder if there's anything else that's missing. Okay, so if I go back to import, I also am curious whether I can tell that the imports, that those groups, that those projects were actually imported, and whether it would let me to import again. So yeah, it clearly recognizes the fact that these two projects were imported, and there isn't a way for me to re-import on top of that. I would imagine I would need to delete the project in GitLab in order to be able to import it again. Okay, so I think that that gives me an idea of what the user experience looks like, and also definitely prompted me to look into a few things and note some of the improvements that we can make in the user experience, as well as in the depth of the integration or the depth of the migration. So be able to migrate more things in an automated way, as opposed to having to manually do some of that. This concludes my walkthrough and the video. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope it was as useful to you as it was for me. Take care.